All right. Phone is on. We got 5, 2. Hey, what's going on, Miss Marilyn Rivers? How are you doing today? How are you? What's going on? What's percolating? What's popping? What's up, Sharon? What's going on? How y'all doing today? We gonna come in after this? Hey, I'm just trying to make my mama proud. I'm good. How are you doing? What's going on? What's happening? Hey, Miss Tiffany Jordan, what's going on, girlfriend? How you doing? Hey, so Will Smith, what else is good? Like some real, like, turn up. Hey, make sure y'all, I'm blessed. You look beautiful, love. You look beautiful, girlfriend. Okay? Thank you. I got a gift I'm giving away today. So make sure y'all call in. Because last week I gave a $25 gas card from BP. Okay? Yes, looking good. Mother Rivers. What's our time?
2 minutes.
2 minutes? Okay. Hey, guys. We got 2 minutes to showtime. Hi, James. Make sure y'all follow me on Facebook and Instagram. Tell everybody you know. The number is 313-729. I'm going to put it in the comments. Y'all, I tore one of my contacts. I feel like I'm seeing double vision. I put the number in there for you guys. I'm good.
1 minute.
1 minute, guys. I'm trying to hurry and put this number in here for y'all. Yo, 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 it's your girl, Zsa Zsa, and you're listening to Yeah, I Said It on Oso Radio, and before I take it back, you know I'm going to add more to it, and I know you heard me the first time. Today is June 21st. Listen, it's Thankful Thursday, Thinking Thursday, Throwback Thursday, whatever you want to call it. Today is Thursday, and guess what? It is the first day of summer, okay? Summer, summer, summertime. We're going to get into some of that Will Smith later on for the show. But in the meantime, in between time, listen, y'all, it is a beautiful day today. The last couple of days, we have been experiencing some really bipolar weather because you know how Michigan is and you know how we do up in the metro Detroit, okay? It could be raining. It could be snowing. Hell, it could be raining and snowing all in the same day. Snowing on one side of the street and raining on the opposite side. So let's just be grateful that we are alive to even endure this type of weather, because there are some people that are in jail that don't even see the sun, the rain, or anything else. I want to send a special shout out to all my fans and viewers that are listening to us and listening to me on Yeah, I Said It on Oso Radio. Make sure you go and download the app. If you don't have the app, make sure you go to www.osoradio.com. I'm live right now on my social media pages. You can follow me at Zsa Zsa C. Hubbard on Facebook and Instagram, and you can check me out right here, right now, live. Listen, I don't know where y'all been or what y'all been doing this week, but it has been a crazy week. And when I say crazy, I mean crazy. We first started off our week, well, started off our weekend with celebrating Father's Day, and please forgive me because I did not mention last week on the show Happy Father's Day, and I want to send a special Happy Father's Day to all of the wonderful fathers out there. And I didn't really get a chance to touch bases on it on the show last week because I was talking about the dating dilemma, because I had a dating dilemma and it was just off the chain and ain't nobody got time for none of that. But Happy Father's Day to all of those fathers that are out there, and I hope you enjoyed your Father's Day. And if you didn't get a chance to enjoy your Father's Day, hopefully you'll be able to enjoy this weekend or this week coming up. And if your kids didn't get you nothing for Father's Day, shame on you. Or shame on them. Depends on what kind of relationship you have with your kids. Now, nevertheless, we started off this week with the passing of a young artist, XXX, Tenacion. And a couple months ago, I don't know if you guys have been following me, but I had my son, Tayshawn, and my niece, Nadiri. They were my guests. I had teenagers that were my guests, and we talked about life as a teen, life as young people, the music that they listened to, and we talked about this guy. We talked about his music. We talked about his lifestyle. They talked to me about, you know, him worshiping idols and different things of that nature. But nevertheless, the young man, unfortunately, was killed, it was confirmed that he was killed on Tuesday, but he was actually killed Monday. And one of the things that I found that was so distasteful and disgraceful is the fact that there were so many people that were there witnessing the demise of someone and not willing to step in and try to not just save a soul or a human being, but just being more hands on. And I find that on the show today, we're going to talk about XXX Tenacion. We're going to talk about our unfortunate president, number 45, and the Zero Tolerance Act with these kids being in these camps. It's nothing but history repeating itself. And then finally, we're going to talk about social media. Is it really helping us or is it hurting us? So I'm going to be jumping around, but just follow me, because those of you that know me know that I'm going to keep y'all on a straight path and let y'all know what's popping. I want to have send a shout out to all my people that's following me on Facebook. What's up, I see. What's up, Jenny Jen? What's going on, Crystal? What's up, Sharon, John? What's going on? What's happening? What's going on, Catty Rebo? Sober to the most. I see you, baby. Tiffany Jordan, what's going on, baby? I see you, baby. Rochelle Denise, Monet Jackson, what's going on, James? You want to get fit? Go check out my homeboy, James. He works at Metro Detroit and Oakland County and Macomb County. He'll come get you together, get you a six-pack together. Listen, we're talking today about social media. I don't know who this is calling me, but they shouldn't be calling me because they know I got a show today, but it's all good. In the hood. It's your girl, Zsa Zsa. You're listening to Oso Radio. And before I take it back, I'm going to add more to it. So this young man first of all, what has America come to at this point? Because it's just like, I'm just at a point where it's just like, what's really happening? You know, like between our leaders that are leading our country to the things that are happening in other countries, to the things that are just happening within our city, things that are just happening in our neighborhoods and communities, and then things that are happening in our own personal lives. And so when you add all those things together, you have this big gumbo pot of just stuff. And sometimes you just don't know what to do, because stuff is just happening all around us and everywhere. You know, you turn on the news and you don't want to watch the news too long because that's depressing. And then you look at your situation and you're like, that's kind of making me feel some type of way. So I just want to employ you guys and let you all know that God is in control no matter what happens or who's in leadership or who's in charge. Just stay on your two feet and on your toes. But anyway, first day of summer. Happy first day of summer to all of you. You're listening to your girl, Zsa Zsa. Yeah, I said it on Oso Radio. And before I take it back, I'm going to add more to it. And I know you heard me the first time. This is the thing. Are we really making America great again? Because I put up my post yesterday and I put that we're not making America great again. We're making America look really dumb. We're looking really crazy right now. And it's almost to the point where it's just really downright disrespectful as a citizen. And it's like you have somebody that's in leadership making dictatorship decisions, even though we're in a bureaucratic and democratic country where we're liberated and free to make the decisions that we want. However, we're putting stipulations on the very people that have helped make America great. Immigrants have helped cultivate our culture, our country. I mean, who do you think built this country? Who do you think? Mexicans are the ones who got all every corporate company, okay, that has grass, bushes, dirt. Mexicans did it. Anybody who's ever ate a banana in strawberries and blueberries, anybody who's ever had some grapes, immigrants plucked them, peeled them. Anybody ever peeled an orange? Want to know how you got that orange at the grocery store? Immigrants. You know, like those little punchkis you get on Fat Tuesdays? You know where those came from? Immigrants. Them tazillions and braids y'all like to have and wear? Immigrants. Okay, the Coney Island, immigrants. Everywhere you go, there are immigrants. Doctors, immigrants. Dentists, immigrants. I mean, for me personally, gas station owners, gas immigrants. I'm just trying to figure out where does this make sense? And then not only that, but how does it make sense for kids? Like, it's one thing for you to detain a family together, but to continue to separate and break down other races other than the European race is downright disrespectful. And at this point, it's just pretty much like they're saying, we don't care. What you gonna do about it? And I mean, at this point, I feel like whatever you're doing right now in your life, get yours as fast as you can get it. Do what you can. If you want to start a business, I told you that. Y'all don't be listening to me, but y'all gonna learn today. Y'all gonna learn today. When he was running for office and I told all of y'all to get out there and vote, I said he's gonna be changing things. All y'all out there who's got these bridge cards and free Medicaid and Social Security and all these different benefits that you guys are enjoying or think that won't ever go away, they will. Like right now, the food stamp program, you chicks out there and fellas that got that EBT card, they are implementing a program where they're going to be eliminating that card as a whole entirely. They're going to have a box of food. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I said it. A box of food that's full of dry canned goods. And that is going to be a representation of what you and your family get. They're going to give you a certain amount of boxes for the certain amount of representation in your family because of the over excessive spending that they feel that EBT and food stamp recipients have, and they're not buying the proper nutrients that they need in order to have a healthy lifestyle. So pretty much what they're saying is that all y'all people who got bridge cards, y'all ain't doing nothing but buying a bunch of snacks, and y'all not buying no real food. Y'all ain't doing nothing for real with it. Now listen, when I had a bridge card and when I got a bridge card, listen, let me tell you something, honey, I was getting lobster, crab legs, whatever I could get, steak, filet mignon, all of that. If you got a bridge card, buy quality things. Don't just buy chips and snacks and stuff that has nothing to do with nothing, because they're watching. If you go to the grocery store, they now itemize all of the things that are purchased when you utilize your EBT card. So I need you guys to be woke and stay awake. Don't be woke and then fall asleep. And then in the midst of the war, you ain't nowhere to be found. We can't use you because you ain't hip to what's happening in your world, in your society. We got to stay abreast about what's going on and what's happening because it affects all of us. Either some way, shape, or form, it affects us. So are we really making America great again, or are we just allowing buffoonery and individuals that are in leadership to just lead us into a straight demise? And it almost seems as if things are happening in a way where it looks really, really bad, but it's shining the light on the ignorance that we have in America. You don't really realize how ignorant these individuals are until you see a situation like this. You don't really realize how racist your employees or coworkers are until this comes to play. I'd never forget the moment that I really found out how people really feel about the African-American culture, minorities, and different things of that nature. You better pay attention to these people, how they react to stuff like this, how they react. Like, if you got coworkers and they're not bothered or they're not feeling like there are this is a concern, that's a problem. I'm going to go to my Facebook. Katie Rebo says, unfortunately, there are millions behind that are under 45, mainly white people. They don't care what he does. He got to do better and stop blaming. We got to do better as a people and stop blaming them. Absolutely, I agree. We got to do better and stop blaming Trump, Lump, whoever's in office. We have to do better. And speaking of doing better, we have to get to a point where it starts with us. And I think I talked about this on a show a couple of weeks ago about doing a self-assessment. I do a self-assessment every day. Any situation, any relationship, whether it be platonic, longevity, friendship, relationship, we have to do a self-assessment. What am I doing? How did I do it? What did I do it? How did I do it as it relates to me? Was I nice about my answer? Was my attitude reflective to what I really meant? Did I really look at all the facts or was I ready to tell my story first? See, some people are so consumed with getting their story out first that we fail to look at facts. So you gotta see, it's a difference between telling your story first and then actually getting the facts, because we live in a world where whoever gets the story out first, it almost seems as if it's the truth. We didn't even know if the boy was dead, the Triple X Tenacious young man. People were saying he wasn't dead. People were saying he was dead. Which one is it? See, we're so focused on getting stories out first that we're not looking at the facts as they come. And people, when they come to me and they want to tell me something about somebody else, I always ask them, okay, well, what's the other scenario of the situation? Because we always know that there are two sides to the truth, three sides to every story, the truth, the lie, and the real truth, whatever, however it go. But nevertheless, we have to do a self-assessment. We have to check on us and say, okay, the mistakes that are being made in America by mankind and the leaders that are leading us, are we in position where we acknowledge the mistakes that we make? Do we apologize for the things that we do when we offend someone? When we don't make wise decisions? When we don't tell the whole truth? When we conceal evidence that is pertinent to other people? When we do things that potentially may hurt us or affect other people? Do we go back and apologize? And I remember being in rehab and going to this class about and I think that's one of the 12 steps is going back to the people who you've offended during your time of whatever situation you were dealing with, when you were dealing with substance abuse. And you have to go back and you have to make amends with those people. And it also talks about that in the Bible. Go to your brother and sister if you have fought against them. And are we that prideful where we can't apologize for the mistakes that we made? Like, for instance, our president put out an order to separate families because of their citizenship in the United States, only to turn around and put them, quote unquote, or try to put them back with their families when you had already made a mistake. Are we that prideful and that immature where we can't say, you know what, America, I made a mistake. I should have never allowed, or whatever the case may be, because pride comes before destruction, before a downfall. And as Lord is my witness, I put this on my mama and my daddy and my brother who are deceased. 9 times out of 10, this man that's our president is going to be one, impeached or killed. That's just what's going to happen. And 9 times out of 10, we're going to start seeing less of him in physical settings and more so in a protected setting, like coming from the office or the White House. He's not going to be so much physical. You're not going to see him at a lot of different places like we've seen him in time past, because of the decisions that he's making and the challenges that he's coming across, and the people that are becoming more boisterous. But are we only boisterous on social media? Like, I'm so over people who are so bold and bodacious behind the screen, but you don't have any backbone when it comes to actually standing up for the things that are right and saying this is wrong, this is not right. And we will complain amongst ourselves and to ourselves, but yet we never put in the actual time and attention that it takes to do what's right. My son was failing in his U.S. history class. And I told his teacher, I asked his teacher, I said, well, why are they not learning about Black history? What can my son do to not fail his class? Lo and behold, long story short, the teacher ended up being racist and very discriminative. And it showed in his behavior. You got to pay attention to people's behavior traits. People don't change overnight. You got to pay attention to the repetitive behavior. Something my ex-husband taught me is that if a person never changes, you better know that this is who they are. This is what they represent. This is who they are. They are not going to change. Our president is not going to change. This is how he is. It's probably going to get worse before it gets better. You got to get your money together. I'm telling you, get your coin together. Save your money to the best of your ability. And put you up a safe stash just in case you ever got to move real fast and get some stuff popping, because we don't know the behind the scenes of what's happening politically. And I say that because I've been in politics. I worked for Wayne County for 10 years. I started off in politics when I was in high school, 14 years old, going to Lansing, standing before the Capitol. And so with that being said, I know that there are two sides to this politic world. You have the side that they want you to see, that's for the public eye to let you know, hey, everything's okay, don't you worry. But then there's also that back end story that you all don't get to see, where everybody's panicking and in an uproar. Of course, they're going to have representation, and of course, our Secretary of State and those who are our spokespeople who have to let us know that everything is going to be okay, because that is proper protocol. It wouldn't be politics if they didn't do it that way. But you all have to be mindful that don't just take the first story as it comes along. And we have to get to a point where we are apologetic when we do things wrong. When you offend somebody and you do something wrong, you apologize. Don't be so prideful that you can't get to a point where you say, you know what? My bad. I didn't do right. And you're listening to your girl, Zsa Zsa. Oh, yeah, I said it. And before I take it back, I'm going to add more to it. You're listening to Oso Radio. Make sure you go download the app. Go to www.osoradio.com. Make sure you tune in. Listen, I got a special mystery prize sponsored by the Kelly's Kids Foundation. Now, last week, I gave out a $25 gift card. Crystal Rice from Black Economic Exchange won that gift card, and it was truly a blessing because I am her daughter's mentor. So it was a triple blessing because I feel like I, you know, this is what I do, you know, and so I know that it went to a great cause, and she's a great individual, and I know that she will put it to great use. But the Kelly's Kids Foundation is sponsoring another great gift, and it's a mystery gift. And so with that being said, make sure you guys call in 313-729-3258. Let me know your thoughts. Let me know how you feel about the young man that was the artist at Triple X Tenation, who was brutally killed in Florida, as well as our current president and his dumb ass decisions. I say that wholeheartedly until the saints forgive me, but you don't have a heaven or hell to put me in, so praise the Lord. It's just getting to the point where it's just ridiculous. And so I also want you to chime in and talk about, is social media helping us or is it hurting us? Is it putting us in a position where we're actually being boisterous? Because I know when it came down to making those type of impacts like they did in the 60s, when they marched for causes and they stopped bus systems from discrimination and separation and those things. We were effective when it came to not having a phone in our hands because we weren't occupied by things that were on social media. And don't get me wrong, I for one get lost in the sauce. I'll go on social media saying I'm looking for one particular thing, and the minute I see something else, I start clicking other posts and doing other stuff, and before you know it, I'm on social media for a whole hour and I can't get what I gotta get done because I done took an hour looking at what so and so and them doing and looking at this meme. And I'm good for sending out memes and videos, y'all. If y'all ever got one from me, if I see something that's funny or I feel like it's up our alley or it's reflective of something, I'm sending it out to everybody that I can send it out to. But is it helping me or hurting me? Listen, we're going to get into some Will Smith summertime. It's summertime. Happy first day of summer. You're listening to your girl Zsa Zsa on Yeah, I Said It. Before I Take It Back, I'm going to add more to it. You're listening to Oso Radio. Make sure you log in, download, make sure you get the app on osoradio.com. You can Google it, search it. Make sure you check us out. I want y'all to call in. We're going to listen to this Will Smith, get into this Will Smith summertime. Will Smith is hot. He popping, y'all. He popping. Jada Pinkett Smith is popping with her Red Table Talk show. Willow and Jaden back rapping, and the oldest son is cute or whatever. The whole little Smith clan is popping. I can't wait to get remarried again to my whole little clan. We can get to popping, getting this coin, okay? Because that's the plan. Get you a family, get you a man or a woman, get your kids. Y'all all get a coin, some businesses. Don't be sitting around there being all in love and oh, I love you and we broke. Now I'll pass on that. Anyway, it's your girl Zsa Zsa. You're listening to Yeah, I Said It. And before I take it back, I'm going to add more to it. You're listening to Will Smith, Summertime. And I'm going to get back with you after this song. Hey. We good? All right, cool. Hey. I need y'all to call in so we can have dialogue, guys. Caddy Rebos, Typewriter Thug, call in. We want to hear that deep, tender Teddy Pendergrass voice that you got. Okay? I put the number in the link. I need you guys to call it. Okay? Mm-hmm. Hey. Then don't try to fix it. Hey. Hey. Just summertime. Summer, summer, summertime. Summer, summer. Okay, what we doing next? What y'all want to hear, guys? What song y'all want to hear? What's a good summer song?
Idea. Summertime is from Summertime, so this is how we do it.
Oh my God, this is how we do it. Sha-na-na-na-na.
From there, I went to the Gap Band Outstanding.
Okay. Okay.
From there, it'll go to Jay-Z, Excuse Me, Miss.
Ooh.
Then from there, I get newer and I went to Drake, Nice for What.
I like DJ Quada. DJ, wait, no, that's not DJ Quada. You're not Carter. You are Carter. Okay. DJ Carter. You got my whole little playlist together. Wait, I see you waves on fleek. Listen, my DJ waves on fleek, y'all, okay? I know everybody into the little natural fro thing, but he got his waves on. I'm seasick. I see you waves. Listen, I love a good man with a good cut. Some good waves. I like that natural look too, but
I do too. I can't stand the afro look.
You know, I like the afro look. It's okay, you know. But I like a good clean cut. Just we want to smell you. Smell what you smell like. For real. Angelini! What's going on, girlfriend? How are you? Hey, Anjali, I need you to get some information for me. What time we got left on that?
This one, 1:30.
Okay, I gotta get my water. I'm thirsty.
Yeah.
I'm back. Did you miss me? Y'all remember that from Martin? And what was his name? Davis. What's his name? He be like, did you miss me? Did you miss me? His name was, y'all know, on the Martin show, y'all remember? Because you remember Martin had a radio show, WZUP, and his friend, can y'all tell me? Whoever can tell me the character name of the man that was on Martin.
I was about to say the name.
Don't say it. Whoever can tell me, call in. Okay, I got 15 seconds. I want y'all to call in right now.
Five, four, three, two, one.
Yo, it's your girl Jaja. You're listening to Yeah, I Said It on Oso Radio. And before I take it back, baby, guess what? I'ma add mo to it, baby. Listen, it's the first day of summertime. You just heard Will Smith, summertime, baby. And listen, it's a beautiful day. It's a blessing to have a day like this. And actually, did y'all know that today is going to be the longest day of the year? It's going to be maybe a minute longer today in terms of time. And then the time is going to trickle back 3 minutes. Now, ain't that something? How is it that we got 24 hours in a day, but yet y'all gonna take 3 minutes away? How's that feasible? How's that possible? Now, listen, your girl don't know a lot of things, but one thing she know, two things for certain. How is y'all controlling the time? I mean, how, Sway? Like, this, I don't get that. But, you know, I'm not gonna, you know, ain't nobody trying to be kidnapped by the Secret Service or nothing, because I'm asking too many questions, because, you know, listen, call in right now. The number's 313-729-3258. I got a prize here sponsored by the Kelly's Kids Foundation. And listen, I want to know, can you tell me, call in right now. The number's 313-729-3258. If you can tell me on the Martin Show with Martin Lawrence, he had a radio show, WZUP, and he would say, what's up, or whatever he would say. And he had an arch enemy who also had a radio show. And the guy would say, do you miss me? I don't know the name of this character. Whoever can call this number, 313-729-3258, and can tell me who this person is. I got a caller. Let's see who this caller is calling in right now. What's up, caller? You're calling into Yeah, I Said It on Oso Radio. What's your name? Crystal! What's up, girl? You keep getting through. I'm not giving you no prize today. Okay, well, tell me what's going on, girlfriend. Yeah. 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 Okay. Yeah. So let me ask you this, since you're a social media manager, in the wake of the young man XXX Tenation that was killed, and you have his dead body across the world that's being recorded, what are your thoughts on that? Ooh, our people been standing by watching our people get killed. Girl, where you at? Come on to the show. You coming on next week, girl. I'm telling you, I'm taking your brain, your lungs, and your mouth, and you're coming straight here, right here, having a seat next to me, because you just said something that was so critical. You said our people have been standing by watching our own people get killed. Why is that? Why is it that we have so much to say behind closed doors, but when it's time to actually put in the footwork to actually make our voice stick, why is it that we don't? Fear. Afraid to be judged by their peers. Yeah. Yeah, it's restrictions. Right. They definitely, our ancestors definitely died. And they died for us to be in the positions that we're in now, but it's too many of us to not be in more positions. You know what I mean? And I think that comes along with one, knowing who you are and knowing where you fit in the world and being okay if somebody makes it to the place where you feel you should be before you get there. You know what I mean? Like even within my own circle in my own world, and I'm gonna let you go after this, but there were a lot of people that I helped get them in the position they are in today. I don't look for them to say, hey, Ja, thank you for looking out, or thank you for those words of wisdom, or that support, or whatever the case may be, whatever the situation may be. And they have been able to be blessed and exceed and surpass me in certain areas. And I had to get to a point mentally where I had to think about it like, well, you know, because sometimes we get jealous, and that is a natural emotion. Jealousy is a natural emotion. And I think sometimes we as Black people, we don't know where to put that jealousy, and we don't like to acknowledge the emotions that we're dealing with. Okay, I'm mad. Okay, why am I mad? What are the situations that have caused me to be mad? How can I get to a place where I'm no longer mad about the situation? And so sometimes we get to a place where we're not acknowledging and doing, and going back to that self-assessment about checking ourselves. We so quick to put another person in a place and throw shade and say how we feel about another person and how they live, and when we're not looking at how we live and how we're treating people or how we're making certain decisions. You know what I mean? So I just want to thank you, Crystal, for that comment. Listen, call in right now, 313-729-3258 if you want to comment. We're talking about XX Tenation. We're also talking about President Trump and the zero tolerance policy, separating these kids from their parents, as well as, is social media helping us or hurting us? Call in. I got a prize right now, sponsored by the Kelly's Kids Foundation. If somebody can call in right now, 313-729-3258, and tell me who was the man on Martin that also had a radio station that was competing against Martin. And he said whenever he would come into the room, did you miss me? Who was that character? Call in right now, 313-729-3258. It's your girl, Zsa Zsa. You're listening to Yeah, I Said It on Oso Radio. And before I take it back, I'm going to add more to it. And I know you heard me the first time. Before we went off to the break from Will Smith, Summertime, and let me tell you, it is the summertime, baby, okay? So if you ain't got your edges laid down, you might want to go do it. If you ain't got no braids in your hair, girlfriend, you might as well go ahead and get you some braids up in there, because it's going to be hot, okay? You ain't got to be worried about pressing, curling your hair. This week has been absolutely one of the most sad. It's been very sad, a very sad week with all of the things that have transpired from Monday's account up until this point. We got a caller. Let's see who it is. Yo, it's your girl, Zsa Zsa. You listening to Yeah, I Said It. What up, though? Who is this? What's going on, Ling Ling? Listen, I love Angelina. This is my girl, Angelina. Now, I have known Angeli for how long have I been knowing you, Angeli? Maybe about 7 years, 6 years. And first of all, her and my son were the same height for some time, quite some time. And it's so funny because my baby is so much taller than her. And she's so cute. I love Angeli. She's like a little, you remember on Step Brothers, and the lady told the one brother in the bathroom, like, I just want to take you and put you in my vagina and stuff you up there. And when you move around, you know, I feel it because of your hair. I don't want to stuff Angeli in my vagina, but I do love Angeli just that much because she's just so cute. I worked with her downtown in Wayne County. What's up, Angelina? Do you have the answer to the question? Who is the, who? what he would say. Oh, man. Well, Angelique, guess what? You won a mystery prize from the Kelly's Kids Foundation. Do you want to know what it is? Okay, guess what? It is a Kelly's Kids Foundation t-shirt from the Kelly's Kids Foundation. Hey, listen, let me know where you're going to be at later, girl, so I can make sure I drop it off to you and make sure I get a big old hug and kiss from you. So, wait a minute, Jen. Now, you didn't call in, Jen, so you can't be making comments on the three-way now, okay? Now, I understand me and you as sister friends, but nah, you're going to have to be careful, little Jen Jen. I love y'all. They're my girls from down in Wayne County. Listen, I love my coworkers so much. It's a blessing when you have a career in a position where you can go ahead and love the people that have loved on you. And one thing's for sure, two things for certain. Those women have supported everything that I've done more than my relatives. And that is a blessing in itself. And I'm so grateful to find and have genuine people, because when you get genuine people in your life, you want to keep them around. Now, we don't talk every day, but when we do, we talk and we love and show love. And I'm going to support anything and everything they do. Now, I missed your birthday party, but don't charge it to my head, charge it to my heart. I had a lot going on, okay? I still love you. Thank you, boo. It's my girl, Angelique. Thank you for calling in. She got the prize mystery pack from the Kelly's Kids Foundation. Call in right now if you want to talk about... Now, Angelique, did you want to talk on the subject of social media, Donald Trump, or XXXTentacion while I got you on the line? Girl, it's all crazy. All madness. So what do you think in light of all the things that are going on? What do you suggest for the people? Absolutely. We got to come together, love on one another, and stop being so divided. Listen, it was my girl, Angelique. She won the prize from the Kelly's Kids Foundation. Listen, we're going to get back into the subject. Love you, Angelique Lane. I'm about to get off the line. Peace out. Listen, it's your girl, Jaja. You're listening to Yeah, I Said It on Oso Radio. And before I take it back, I'm going to add more to it. That was Angelique. She just won a special prize from the Kelly's Kids, sponsored by the Kelly's Kids Foundation. They help low-income families who are dealing with and supporting low-income families that are dealing with terminal illnesses. And so they provide resources and programs that help out those low-income families. That is a nonprofit organization that I started on behalf of my mother when she passed away 3 years ago. And so we're going to continue to support all of those families and those people that are in need, brought to you by the Kelly's Kids Foundation. And Angelique just won her prize pack. Listen, you're listening to Jaja on Yeah, I Said It on Oso Radio. Before I take it back, I'm going to add more to it. And I know you heard me the first time. Make sure y'all go and download that app or go to www.osoradio.com to make sure that you are finding out the latest news of what's popping, what's happening in the world of Oso. Okay, it's your girl Jaja. Before I take it back, I'm going to add more to it. We're talking... Is social media helping us or hurting us? We're talking President number 45 and his leadership and the decisions that he's making on behalf of our country. And where exactly is he leading us? Is he leading us into the demise that the Bible talks about? That there be rumors of wars and different things of that nature that they talk about in the Bible? Where are we being led to? Are we that quick and so social mediably bound that we're quick to elect anybody? I said a couple of years ago when he was even running that we have to be more boisterous. We have to be more visible. It's not enough for us to complain about things at our kitchen table. It's not enough to complain about those things over a blunt or over a drink at the bar. It's not enough for us to talk about it and clap and say amen at church in the pew. It's not enough. It's not enough. And I'm really disappointed in a lot of our churches, because church is the foundation from which all of this stuff kind of came from. I mean, in God we trust. Our president quoting scriptures and misinterpreting scriptures that allow us to think that it's okay for slavery. See, sometimes people like to misuse the very thing that's supposed to help us, like the Bible. You're using the Bible to justify slavery or to justify your terroristic acts. That is not okay. This behavior and this inhumane behavior that you're allowing is not okay. And we have to get to a point where we're not okay. Just because you feel like it's not affecting you immediately, it will affect you down the line. Those of you who don't have children, you may not be sympathetic, but you should really be empathetic, because it could be your kid, it could be your niece, it could be your cousin next. You know, you think because, oh, it hasn't touched me, or it's not about me, or it hasn't done anything to me, that it doesn't qualify. No. When there is a human issue, especially when it comes to our children, that's a everybody issue. I mean, because even if you don't have kids now, you eventually want kids someday. And if you don't want kids no day, you got some nieces and nephews, some little cousins. These could possibly be the kids that are being sexually trafficking across the country. I mean, we don't know what they're doing with these kids. We don't know if their kids are even being accounted for. Are they doing a daily count like they do in the jails? Are they going by every schedule or every rotation for the transition of officers? Like how are people being accounted for? How are these kids being cared for? Like, is there a 24-hour, 7-day surveillance that can be seen across the border so we all are aware of what's really happening to these young people? We have to get to a place where we demand a better situation, not just look for a better situation. Listen, let me tell you something. One thing's for sure, two things for certain. You are not going to shit on me and call it meatloaf. You're not going to piss on me and call it rain. It ain't happening. And you got to get to the point in your life where you're not going to allow things to be mediocre. You're not going to allow people to do you or treat you any kind of way. You're not going to allow injustices if you have a voice to speak on it. Because not speaking on it is just as worse as being a part of it. It's just as worse. It's like knowing you have the ability and the propensity to change somebody's life by being boisterous about a situation, but yet you choose not to. And I'm very disappointed in how our mindsets have become so engulfed with things that don't even matter in comparison to things that we should be focused on. Like the fact that, did y'all know summer school is only going to be for kindergartners and third grade? This is the last year, summer school, this year for Detroit Public School Community District. They're getting ready to change a lot of policies within our school system that y'all don't even realize. They changed the name of DPS right in front of us, right in front of our face. If y'all don't think that that's important, just think of how many other things are being changed right under our nose and we don't even know. Y'all got to pay attention. Don't be so caught up in, I got to work, I got to go home, I got to go to church, and you're not aware of what's going on. Y'all need to get out, get to some of these social events, get to talking to some of these people, get to reading some of these books and magazines other than what's on social media. Read an article a day or once a week. Find out what's going on, because the truth of the matter is those things that are important that they were saying back in the day about putting important stuff in writing, so because they know we're not going to read it, it's still true to this day. I find out so much more stuff by reading newspapers, magazines, articles than I do on social media. Now, I may find out the drama first through social media, but if I'm trying to find something that's substantial of some resources, I'm in a bind, I need some help, I need to figure out what's going on, y'all got to read and stop taking every story that y'all hear first as it being the truth. It may just be the story you got. It may just be your version. Listen, it's your girl, Zsa, and you're listening to Yeah, I Said It. And before I take it back, I'm going to add more to it. And I know you heard me the first time. Make sure you go download the app. Make sure you go tune in on the web, online, on the internet at www.osoradio.com. Make sure you follow me on Instagram and social media. Listen, we're going to get into some music, because listen, before I take it back, I'm going to add more to it. And I know you heard me the first time. Listen, if you want to be on the show, if you have a talent, if you want to advertise with us, you got a business, listen, I want to represent represent you. You got a shirt you want me to wear. I got a following. Let's help each other out. Because we will never be like California. We will never get to Atlanta until we learn to actually work together. It's a difference between saying, hey, I want to work with you. I support you. In comparison to what you need me to do, what time you need me to do it, and when do I need to be there. See, we got to stop talking about it and stop listening to people that do all this talking and don't do no moving. I don't converse with people that I don't see anything happening in their life. You can't tell me how to own a home if you still rent. You can't tell me how to be successful if you ain't done nothing successful. You can't tell me how to be an actor or an actress if you never acted. You can't tell me how to start a business if you never had one and you've always been an employee. You can't tell me how to be a parent if you never had a kid. So you got to stop listening and getting your counsel from people who don't have true wisdom or counsel or experience. We're getting and asking for advice or getting our opinions from people who are not even on our level of intellect. I mean, I truly am a sapiosexual. And for those of you that don't know what a sapiosexual is, you get turned on by knowledge, intellect, by others, the ability to converse and have dialogue by just using your mind. You get turned on just by somebody using your mind. Ain't nothing like a good conversation about life, a good conversation about where you're going in the future, a good conversation about what your next steps are, a good conversation about where you stand in politics and where you stand in life, or where you stand with women's rights and men's rights and black men being in prison and our youth and being led by somebody who's a devil worshiper and then turns around and says that he wants people to learn from his life. See, we got to get to a point where we are conversing with people who are going the direction in which we're going. I don't want to talk to you if you plan on still staying at McDonald's next year. That's a problem. Now, don't get me wrong. Working at McDonald's ain't the problem. It's the fact that you want to stay there, that you're not looking to move up in the ladder. Like if you've been on a job for 2 to 3 years or 4 to 5 years and you have not gotten one, an increase in your pay, to a better position, and you're still doing the same thing with the same pay for years, that's a problem. That means that you don't value what you have to offer. I value who I am, and I ain't lowering my standards for nobody. And we got to get to a place where, one, you're not comfortable. That's so right, Crystal, because comfortability will cause us not to move. It'll cause us not to try. And the fear of the opinions of others. I have graduated from Opinion Academy. Okay. I've graduated. I've got my doctorate in it. I am certifiably over and unbothered by other people's opinions. Do I ask for people's opinions as it relates to my businesses and marketing? But as it relates to me personally, if I'm not asking you for your advice, I'm not looking for you to give me none, because I ain't asking nothing from you. So the thing about it is that you got to be mindful of where you're getting your counsel and where you're getting your wisdom from. And not only that, but you have to get to a point where we are effective and we're making movements. See, when we're working together, we can be effective and knock down things. We are all powerful individuals. Don't get me wrong. We are all powerful in our own right. All of us. We are all powerful with whatever it is we do. But we are even more dangerous when we work together. If you say, hey, Ja, I got a play I'm in, we gonna come shut that play down. Hey, I just opened up a business, we gonna come shut that place down. But we got to get to the point where that's a desire. You can't be a hater and a helper at the same time. And see, that's the mentality that our president has, because he's a hater and trying to help at the same time. How is it that within the same breath that you take and separate families, you turn around in the same breath and try to put them back together? You can't. That's an oxymoron. You're listening to your girl, Ja Ja. Yeah, I said it. And before I take it back, I'm going to add more to it. I know that you heard me the first time. DJ Carter, how much time we got on the floor, on the clock? Because I want to make sure that we pop it and we stay in line, because my goal, one of my biggest goals, is to be on time. I'm very bad at time, guys. Always late, and I'm really working on time because I'm doing a self-assessment. I know that I'm always late. And because I know this about me, I'm working on being on time, because being on time is professional. It means you mean business. So in order for us to be taken seriously as a people, you got to start with those small things. Start small, then work your way up to those bigger things that you're trying to obtain and accomplish. Where we at, DJ Khaled, on time?
Yeah, 10 minutes.
We got a whole 10 minutes, y'all, so you know it's about to be popping. We going to get into this music. What you got for us? Earth, Wind, and Fire, who you got?
This is how we do it.
This is how we do it. Sha-na-na-na-na-na-na-na. Listen, it's your girl, Zha Zha. You're listening to Oso Radio. You're listening to my show. Yeah, I said it. And before I take it back, I'm going to add more to it. We're talking about number 45, our president. We're talking XXXTentacion and unfortunately his demise. And is social media really helping us or is it hurting us? Where are we at in the world right now? Are we working together to really build a community? Or are we just kind of all doing our own things, hoping that we're going to support each other? We got to get back to the basics. We got to do things that we know works. Okay? Listen, it's your girl, Zha Zha. You're listening to Yeah, I Said It. It's the first day of summer. We listen to Will Smith, Summer, Summertime. We're about to get into this Montel Jordan. This is how we do it. Listen, before I take it back, I'm going to add more to it. And I know you heard me the first time. You listen to your girl, Zha Zha, on Yeah, I Said It on Oso Radio. Make sure you follow me on Instagram, Facebook. I follow back. Listen, I'm a helper. I ain't no hater. Listen, we're going to get into this Montel Jordan. This is how we do it. We'll be back after this, y'all. Hey. Okay, after the song goes off, I want you guys to call in so we can have some dialogue on the phone. Okay, so I need you to expound on your opinions by calling in. I did add the number on the timeline, so you're going to have to kind of scroll up to check the number, but it's 313-729-3258. Right now we have Montel Jordan playing. This is how we do it. After this, then we're going to come out of commercial, and then I'll go into, we'll go into either comments on social media or we'll go into the phone call. So if you want to call in and you have an opinion about what it is that you have an opinion about regarding the topic today, then I would love for you to chime in and expound on that. What's up, King Wesley? We have to learn what social was intended for: marketing, promotions, and networking, not confirmation, idealization, and recognition. You better go with these big old educated words, King Wesley. I remember King when I first ran for city council. He supported me. He sure did, him and his brother. Make sure you call in. The number is 313-729-3258. Hands are in the air. Oh, I wanna be player. Ever since I was a lowercase G, but now I'm on my big G. Got the money, $100 bills, y'all. Then you would know. Mine in a big fat truck. You can get yours in a 6-4. Whatever it is. Montel don't ever have to record another song again. Never. He gonna get paid for the rest of his life. This is right up your alley. I can feel it. Thank you. Now I just gotta transfer it over to the radio, to the television, King, so that we can really get it popping. You get it really popping when you get that that TV play, you know. You know how that go. What's his name? What he said? Me, I don't care. And we're making a dash. It's 45 seconds. Okay. Like nobody does. Sorry, guys. I was trying to plug up my charger. Yeah, it's your girl Jaja on Yeah I Said It Also Radio. Boy, I take it back, I'm gonna add more to it. And I know you heard me the first time. Listen, it's the first day of summertime. Listen, if you don't know, now you know. It's a beautiful day. It's Thankful Thursdays. It's Throwback Thursdays. It's Think About It Thursdays. And whatever you're doing, I hope you're doing it right and you're doing it well. Because listen, it's a big world out there and life is happening as we speak. And I just want to tell all of you who are out there that are trying to do something with your life or trying to get your success and your career off the ground, whatever it is that you're trying to do, don't stop doing it. And if they're not, or particular people aren't supporting you, you got to get to the point where you're going to do what you got to do regardless of what anybody's doing, what anybody's saying. And you got to be so focused on your focus that ain't nothing else your focus. And in the midst of all of that being your focus, getting on your grind, getting your stuff together, getting out there, you have to be mindful of what's happening around you, your environment, your surroundings. You have to be so woke and stay awake. Not just woke, but you got to stay awake. See, a lot of us, we talk that I'm woke stuff, but we ain't really staying awake. See, it's one thing when you're woke, okay? You wake up, you're woke. I'm up. That means I'm acknowledging that this is the situation. But staying awake, causes you to go into another level of your thought process. Because now, as you stay woke and you're going throughout your day, you're looking and paying attention to situations as they transpire. And not only that, but you're taking inventory of situations and things that cause you to feel a certain type of way. You can't get mad at people who you allow to hurt you. You can't get mad at people who you allow to disappoint you. We have to get to a place where our expectations for people are very low, but we provide great service. See, the thing about one of the reasons why it's challenging for us to work together as a people, because we get disappointed with each other so fast and we give up. We got to stop giving up on one another. Now, don't get me wrong. I am the cutoff queen, okay? I ain't got time for no dead weight. None. Zero, zilch, nada. My parents are deceased. My brother was just killed in prison. I ain't got time for nobody and play no games with nobody's life. None, zero. This is not a dress rehearsal. This is life. You don't get a part two. This is what it is, okay? So if this is what it is, you better take care of what you have while you still have it. And in the midst of you trying to acquire things and become more of an adult and transition as a parent and transition in your career and do those things that you love to do, and you want to be the best you can be on your job, and you know you want to be the best you can be in your family, you have to learn to do a self-assessment and focus on you and see how you are being a positive or productive citizen, individual, role model. What are you doing? What are you doing? Because we get very critical when we get in situations like, or view situations like the young man XXX Tenation, who was killed, brutally killed. But his lifestyle, the things that he verbalized, did not represent a lot of things. And so when the teens came to the radio show and we talked about it, what's going on, Dejanay? What's happening? Nettles Pastry Shop in the building. When we talked about him, they talked about how he idolized Satan, how he wanted to bring more people into Satan's camp. I think his music was really great. And this lets you know how influential social media has become. Because there were teens, young people that were sad, like a whole, this white boy killed his whole family. I don't know if y'all heard about that. This one boy killed his whole family because he was killed. So don't get me wrong. I love the fact that our young people, admire or have fan favorites, but everybody deserves to live. Nobody deserves to be killed. But he wasn't no Whitney Houston or Michael Jackson. I mean, I said it before. I take it back. I'm gonna add more to it. Nobody deserves to die, for one. Let me be clear on that. But what he represented was not positive. It was not conducive to what it is or the lifestyle that we want to live. So I had a conversation with my son because we talked about this young man and the life that he represented and what it was that he was vocal about. You have to be mindful because it talks about life and death being in the power of the tongue. And it talks about what you speak into the atmosphere will actually be what it will become. I'll never forget one of my friends, Nikki. She talked about how she was supposed to be in a relationship with this guy and how she wasn't supposed to be in a relationship with this other guy. And it was so funny because you have to be mindful about the things that you say out of your mouth. Not just from what you think, but out of your mouth. And you have to be mindful because there are people that are sponges that are soaking up the information that you're putting out there. Is it reflective to what you really or who you truly are? I mean, if I start doing a campaign about smoking squares, y'all gonna be like, Jaja, you smoking Lucy's? You smoking squares? You're gonna be like, when this happened? You know what I'm saying? And don't get me wrong, this is what I would be putting out there. This will be what I'm representing. So we have to be mindful of what it is that we want people to, one, know about us. What are we representing? Two, are we giving ourselves self-assessments? Three, are we working together to build something better within our communities, within our world? Because as you can see, there are people that are leading our country into straight hell. They're leading our country right into a pit. They're leading our country right into the enemy's camp. Anytime that our previous president, President Barack Obama, clearly stated that he wanted to have conversations with the allies, which are considered our enemies, not our allies, but considerably people that we want to work with, dealing with the United Nations, other countries, those that are our enemies, South Korea, North Korea, Russia, all those different countries that we have to work with on a broader scale. See, it's not enough for you to just know your hair came from China or it's from Brazil. It's not enough for you to know that your parts came from China to go to your car. It's not enough for you to know when you go get these new rims for your ride that it's coming from another country. See, y'all not thinking about how the broader picture affects us. See, you just ordered your TV off Amazon and you hoping it's going to be here within 5 to 7 days. But what you don't know is that if there are any issues with our trade within our country, within the imports and exports, it will stop your precious little product from getting right on over to your house and on your porch. Don't be so consumed with your day-to-day living that you're not being mindful of what's going on in the world around you, within our city government, within our state government. I mean, do y'all know Flint still got dirty water? They still got dirty water. This 2 years, 3 years later in the game, they still taking water to Flint. That's a problem. And then you got Sri Thandi and you got the other chick that's running, that's a Democrat, that's running for governor. Y'all, we got to be more visible. We got to be more mindful. We got to ask more questions. I don't even care if it's a dumb question. I don't care if you don't know what kind of question you want to ask. I don't care if you just say, you know what, Jaja, I don't really want to ask a lot of questions. I don't really have too much to say about nothing. I don't really know what's going on, but I'm here at the meeting. I'm tired. I'm sleepy. The kids is hungry, but they're having a meeting today. I think I need to go. We have to get in the habit of being visible, boisterous, and not lowering our standards, because we have to get to a point where this is repetitive behavior. Our president separating or having a leader or person in charge separating families, kids from their mothers and fathers. They did it to us, black people, as slaves. They separated us. Kids, you go with the lead, the head grandma and them who takes care of the kids. You going on the field, daddy. We're going to separate the family. We're going to sell the kids to this slave owner. We're going to sell him to this slave owner so I can make the most from you. And I'm going to keep raping the black woman and keep making more kids with her and making my white wife jealous of the black woman who they tried to become. Isn't that something? I need you all to pay attention. Don't be so engulfed in knowing everything that happens with Love and Hip Hop, Atlanta and Rashida and her cheating husband, Kirk, that you ain't paying attention to your own marriage. Don't be so caught up in what's happening with Cardi B and Offset that you ain't putting yourself in a position to take care of your own kids. She got her check and her coin. You struggling. Don't be so quick to to go jump in the line for J's, and you know you got to pay a DTE bill. We got to get our life together, including me. And I say we because I'm included in that. I don't ever say things to exclude me out of it as to say that I'm better, because I'm not. I'm right there with y'all. I'm on a payment plan right now with DTE and the water company, because they think they gonna charge me all this money for water, and it's only me and Tayshawn, and we don't even use that much. Woke. Okay? Woke. Don't just take things as they are. Either you gonna take it lying down, or you gonna take it standing up. Shit or get off the pot. Either way, something's got to happen. And you got to get to the point where you got to be the person that's going to make it happen, or you're going to watch it happen. And I'm not going to watch it happen. I'm going to make it happen by any means necessary. I'm going to make it happen when I'm on E. I'm going to make it happen when I'm broke. I'm going to make it happen when I ain't feeling good. I'm going to make it happen when I don't feel at my best. We got to get to the point where we want it so bad, or we're at a point in our life where little things just won't do. I'm not going to allow myself to live a mediocre life. I'm not going to allow me to be disrespected by anybody. I'm not going to allow you to disrespect my brand or my business. I'm not going to allow you to treat my kids any kind of way. I'm not going to allow you to disrespect my spouse. I'm not going to allow my spouse to disrespect me. I'm not going to disrespect myself. So we got to get to the point where, one, we're doing self-assessments, being boisterous, and getting to a point where, one, we are being visible. When you're visible, it matters. Men, when you're visible in the lives of your family, it matters. Men, I need you all to step up in the worst way. I mean, I need y'all to step all the way up to the point where you can't step up no more, okay? And if that just means you and your homeboy is the only two from the block that's doing it, then that's just what it is. But men, I need y'all to get to a position where y'all are stepping up and really taking the lead, because it really matters. We as women, we got it. We strong, we black, we powerful, we got it. But we need y'all to come on, help us out. We don't want to be the only powerful people. We want to be powerful with you, boo. Let's be powerful together. Listen, we're going to get into this music, this last little song. What we got next, DJ Carter?
We can go The Gap Band, Outstanding, Jay-Z, Excuse Me, Miss, or Drake, Nice For What. I'll let you pick.
You know what? I'm feeling Nice For What. No, I don't want to be Nice For What to these ninjas. Even though I like that song. Let's go old school Gap Band. I like The Gap Band. I listen to Drake Nice For What enough. That's what's wrong with me. I think that's the problem. I've been listening to Drake too much. Nice For What? Okay? Ain't nobody got time. You're listening to your girl, Zsa Zsa. Yeah, I said it. And before I take it back, I'm going to add more to it. And I know you heard me the first time. Make sure you go download the app, Oso Radio app. Make sure you go follow me on my social media pages. I have Instagram, and I also have a Facebook, Zsa Zsa C. Hubbard. You can follow me. I'm live right now. If you're listening to me on the radio, make sure you go download the app. Call in right now. The number's 313-729-3258. Tell us about how you're feeling about XXX Tenation and his demise. Tell me about number 45 and him spreading and separating these families, these children. What are we going to do about these type of things? We can't just talk about it. We got to be fierce. We got to be bold. God has not given us a spirit of fear, but of love, power, and of a sound mind. And if you got love in your heart, and I'm not talking about no fake love, don't show me no fake love, because I'm going to call you out on it. I do pull whole cards all day long, and I ain't thinking twice about it. You got love in your heart. You got a sound mind, because the mind is what's going to dictate your decisions and your direction. If your mind messed up, then your mood is messed up. Your money is messed up. And believe you me, I know, because the enemy tried to take my mind and I gave it to him. Okay? But I reached back and I stole it back. So you got to get to the point where, one, you got love in your heart, real love, not fake love, because real love is going to make you make wise decisions. Then you got to have the right type of mindset. When you got the right type of mindset, you can do anything you want to do. That's one thing's for sure, two things for certain. When I opened up Detroit Lash Lounge, God let me see that this is the beginning of many. If he allows you a glimpse of what you're capable of doing, or you're connected to somebody who has been successful, or you're visibly able to comprehend the success of someone else, that is a clear indication that you, my friend, are capable of it as well. Listen, it's your girl, Zsa Zsa. Before I take it back, I'm going to add more to it. And I know you heard me the first time. Listen, we got to learn to be helpers and not haters. And finally, you got power. And I'm not just talking about voltage and watt power. I'm talking about power that comes from above and cannot be taken away by anyone. You have to understand and get to a point where you know the power that you have, the power that you possess, and the power that you can give to another person. Power is exchangeable. When you stick a plug in a socket, baby, you get electricity, okay? That's a whole nother story when you're sticking that socket and the plug together, but that's another scenario, another metaphor for another time. But nevertheless, it's your girl, Zsa Zsa. You're listening to Yeah, I Said It. Before I take it back, I'm going to add more to it. I need you guys to be boisterous, be visible, stand up for what you believe in, or sit down and shut up. Get out the way, because you're in the way. You're just in the way if you ain't going to do nothing, okay? All right? Now listen, before I take it back, I'ma add more to it, and I know you heard me the first time. You're listening to Zsa Zsa on Yeah, I Said It on Oso Radio. Listen, we're gonna get into the Gap Band after this. I'ma get out of here. I love y'all. Until next week. How much time we got left? We good? Okay, we're gonna listen to the Gap Band. I love y'all. Make sure y'all follow me. We can go ahead and continue this conversation on my social media pages. I'll see you next week. And make sure if you have a business or you want to be a guest or a co-host on the show, make sure you contact me. 248-688-5861. I post it all the time. Y'all be acting like y'all scared to call me. Call me. I ain't funny acting. I answer my phone. You will be talking to me unless it's my assistant or somebody else that I got answering my phone. So if you got a business that you want to promote, if you have a product that you would like for us to promote or utilize, please contact us. If you'd like to be a guest or co-host on the show, I would love to have your energy in here, but as long as it's positive, because I don't want no negativity, because you will get shut down. Okay? All right. You're listening to your girl, Zsa Zsa. Yeah, I said it. Before I take it back, I'm going to add more to it. I see y'all next week. I love y'all. Here's the Gap Band. What's the name of the song?
Outstanding.
Outstanding. So outstanding, baby. Girl, you knocked me out. I think I'm going to get back in the choir. Psych. We ready? DJ Carter on Yeah, I Said It. Hey, turn it up. Another great show. Yes, Waste. They ain't ready, y'all. I ain't even got all my summer sexy together yet. And I got 4 abs out here, y'all. I got 4 abs. I only asked the Lord for 2, and he blessed me with the... Oh! You see, I almost passed out about my abs, y'all. I'm petty. I'm so petty, I know. I love y'all. See y'all next week. Go. I'm about to get out here on these streets. I hope y'all enjoyed the show. I got a big announcement coming up next month. Y'all, pray my strength. But it's time. It's time to live. It's been time, but it's my time. You got to recognize when it's your time, and you got to acknowledge it. I love y'all. Make sure y'all go follow me. Oh, make sure y'all subscribe to my YouTube. I'm on YouTube too. So if you got to catch up on the videos that you missed from previous weeks, you can catch up on YouTube. Make sure you follow Zsa Zsa's World. Yeah, I said it. Zsa Zsa's World on YouTube. Love y'all.